Hi, I'm Gaylerd. You know, creating slides on an acoustic guitar is one of those techniques that can really put wow factor into your guitar playing. Well, at least when you do it right. But when you do a slide wrong and it doesn't quite sound the way you wanted it to and the way the audience wants to hear it, it can really make your guitar playing, well, sound a bit stale. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to make your slide sound cool, clean, and awesome, just like a big dog. And then I'm going to show you some exercises you can start practicing every day so you can become the guitar player other guys want to be. So get your pick, get your guitar, and meet me in the studio. I'm going to show you how to play slides on an acoustic guitar, big dog style. A slide on a guitar is nothing more than moving from one fret to another. You can move up or you can go down like this. There's up, there's down. That's all a slide is. The key is making sure that the volume of the note stays the same through the entire slide. Listen to this again. That volume's the same. What happens a lot of times is that people will, that slide, the volume of the note will die somewhere along the slide and you lose the whole effect, okay? If that note doesn't sound the same all the way through from beginning to end, you lose the effect. So there's a couple of things that you can do to keep that from happening. Number one, keep your finger down the whole time. You know, it's kind of like when I don't golf, but they say when you go golf and you look down at the ball, you want to keep your head down, keep your head down. Well, when you're sliding on a guitar fret, you want to keep your finger down. And the other thing is keep. Now, let's say you're going to slide with two notes. You want to do the same thing as when you're sliding with two notes that you do with one. So you want to keep the same pressure on both those strings and both those notes. Now in this case we're going to go 2 to 4 and this one goes 1 to 3, right? All you're doing now is you're hitting both those notes or both those strings and doing your slide. Okay, now let me show you a little trick that you can use, and I do this all the time, and this is something you want to put into your big dog guitar playing. Let's say that you're going to do a slide with a chord, okay? One of the things that I do, when I'm playing with more than one string, if I'm going to hit a slide with two or three strings, I'm always going to tick, for instance, let's just do this right here, this slide right here. I've got three strings on this slide. What I'm going to do when I slide is I go down on that first note and all I'm hitting is that one string until I get up to the top of my slide, and then I'm going to hit the top note. Even though I'm holding those two fingers down on that fretboard, I'm just hitting that first note.
Okay,
and here's some exercises that I want you to start practicing, and this will really help you develop the strength in your fingers and the dexterity and the mobility of your fingers for doing slides. All you're going to do is you're going to slide on this first fret to the third fret on the sixth string, and all we're going to do is one slide, just like that. But I want you to be able to use all your fingers in slides. So on the sixth string, we're using the index finger, 1 to 3. Get a same volume. Then I want you to switch to your ring finger, 3rd fret on 5, 3 to 5. I want to give you an exercise where you're going to do a slide going down the fretboard, and you're also going to put in some of your hammer-ons and pull-offs. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to slide down. I'm going to play it for you once, and then I'm going to show you how to do it. It goes, sounds like this. That's a nice little ending to a G. And here's all you're doing. You're going to take that formation. You're going to put your 5th fret on the first with your index and use your pinky to get that 7th fret on 2. And you're going to slide down 2 frets and then do a pull off on that 2nd string So you wind up with the third. This exercise, I'm going to show you how to put some hammer-ons, pull-offs, and slides all together, and then end it with some cool chords. Now, this is a great exercise for finger mobility, for finger strength, finger dexterity, all of those things. Now, it probably will take you a little time to get this exercise down, but it's going to be critical for you, because once you can do this nice and smooth, your slides and your hammer-ons and all of that will come together a lot easier. Let me play it for you one time, and then I'll show you how to do it. Here we go. It's going to go something like this. Tell me that.
Here's what you're going
to do. You're going to do a nice slide from 1 to 3 on that 6th string using your index finger, okay? Once you get to the 3rd fret, you're going to do a hammer on up to 5 using your pinky.